Hello viewers, welcome to your channel Nanna Gyan Foundation and I am Roman. If you are new to my channel, please subscribe to my channel and please click the bell icon. Today's video is a result of somebody's curiosity. Somebody asked me, my child bites a lot and I'm really fed up of its biting habit. Can you tell me what needs to be done? So here is an answer. So today's topic is about how to handle the biting behavior in a child. It is very common to see that the kids develop this biting habit between 14 months to 36 months. And it is very obvious, it is in their developmental phase that they are going into. So let's understand what are the three causes of kids' biting behavior. First is the developmental issue. Second is not expressing the feelings that a child is going through. And third is the environmental. So these are the three causes. Now let's see each one of them. First, the developmental issue that the child goes through. When the child is going through a developmental issue, one reason could be the teething issues. It could be the developmental of oral motor skills. It can also be a cause and effect. Child is trying to imitate. The child wants the attention of the parents. So even it is a time when child is trying to speak, they're developing their vocabulary or their language. So all these are the reasons where the child starts biting it. Now the second, not expressing the feelings. When we say that child, since it is between the toddler to preschool age, the child cannot express their feelings because are not able to express their feelings in words. So they use biting as a medium to express their anger, frustration, excitement at times, anxiety, and even you can say their feelings which are held upon, where they are unable to say something. It is even a sense of protection in their environment if somebody tries to invade their space. So these are the reasons for expressing. Now the third cause is the environment. So one could be the possibility that the environment is very stimulating, which means too many people, noisy, bright light, child is unable to get adjusted to it. It could be a reason of that the child bites, or it could be a reason the child is bored of doing the same. Since we understood the three causes, let's understand what are the prevention methods. So in that case, we can introduce, when we understand that the child is into the biting habit, what needs to be done? First, introduce the different texture food in his eating habits, like chewable foods like raisins, almonds, or the chewable like crunchy stuff like apples, carrots. This will help the child to develop that texture and reduces the sensory thing of biting someone. When it is oral development, let the child play in a wider space so that the child explores the world. Even for the prevention method, we can use blow bubbles and blow windmills. That helps to develop the oral motor skills and that also reduces the tendency of biting. And last, introduce the kids to the larger open spaces, everyday outdoor playing in a big space, so that the whole cross motor skills have been worked. Now even if this is happening, one needs to understand the child would be in some stress or is not able to express his feelings, or the child needs your attention, you're not paying attention. We need to identify the reasons. And it could be a combination of 2-3 reasons. It can be a single reason also. It could be changing as per the mood of a child too. So as a parent, we need to be, or as an educator, we need to be little guesswork to identify the reason. Now, once you have done it, how will you stop it, or what needs to be done for it? One thing, we need to say to the kids in a firm voice without raising the voice or without scolding them. So hold the hands and say, mouth is not to bite. Say it in a firm voice so that he understands that this is something which is not accepted. Do it continuously, or give them the small things that face the wall. Your voice should be clear, and the person the child has bitten, give that child a little more privilege, little more love. That can also help the child to understand that biting doesn't give you attention. It makes the situation more miserable. One shouldn't bite. So it has to be done consistently. So these are the things that we can do it to improve the kids and making them understand that biting behavior is not good. And moreover, even we will understand why is this happening. If it is happening with you and you're working on it and you think it is something very shame of, it's not so. As a parent, we are giving our best to our kids and it is in the developmental phase. So if you like the video, please like, subscribe and comment. Thank you.